Welcome to Chapter 2, Calculations. This module covers the most basic calculations used in the laboratory. QC statistics for each test performed in the laboratory are calculated from the QC database collected by regular testing of control products. The data collected is specific for each level of control. Consequently, the statistics and ranges calculated from this data are also specific for each level of control and reflect the behavior of the test at specific concentrations. The most fundamental statistics used by the laboratory are the mean and standard deviation. The mean or average is the laboratory's best estimate of the analyte's true value for a specific level of control. To calculate a mean for a specific level of control, first add all the values collected for that control. Then divide the sum of these values by the total number of values. For instance, to calculate the mean for the normal control, level 1, find the sum of the data. The sum is 28.7 millimole per liter. The number of values is 7. Therefore, the mean for the normal control is 4.1 millimole per liter. Now that you understand mean, we can move on to standard deviation. Standard deviation is a statistic that quantifies how close numerical values, i.e. QC values, are in relation to each other. The term precision is often used interchangeably with standard deviation. Another term, imprecision, is used to express how far apart numerical values are from each other. Standard deviation is calculated for control products from the same data used to calculate the mean. It provides the laboratory an estimate of test consistency at specific concentrations. The repeatability of a test may be consistent. Low standard deviation, low imprecision. Or inconsistent. High standard deviation, high imprecision. Inconsistent repeatability may be due to the chemistry involved or to a malfunction. If it's a malfunction, the laboratory must correct the problem. It's desirable to get repeated measurements of the same specimen as close as possible. Good precision is especially needed for tests that are repeated regularly on the same patient to track treatment or disease progress. For example, a diabetic patient in a critical care situation may have glucose levels run every 2 to 4 hours. In this case, it's important for the glucose test to be precise because lack of precision can cause loss of test reliability. If there's a lot of variability in the test performance, high imprecision, high standard deviation, the glucose result at different times may not be true. Standard deviation may also be used to monitor ongoing day-to-day performance. For instance, if during the next week of testing, the standard deviation calculated in the example for the normal potassium control increases from 0.08 to 0.16 millimole per liter, this indicates a serious loss of precision. This instability may be due to a malfunction of the analytical process. Investigation of the test system is necessary, and the following questions should be asked. Has a reagent or reagent lot changed recently? Has maintenance been performed routinely and on schedule? Does the potassium electrode require cleaning or replacement? Are the reagent and sample pipettes operating correctly? Has the test operator changed recently? So how do you calculate a standard deviation? You'll need to determine the mean or average of the QC values. You'll also need the sum of the squares of differences between individual QC values and the mean. Finally, you'll need the number of values in the data set. Although most calculators and spreadsheet programs automatically calculate standard deviation, it's important to understand the underlying mathematics. Therefore, let's look at an example using the same data set from before. Begin by calculating the mean. First, add all the values collected for that control. Then divide the sum of these values by the total number of values. Now that the mean has been determined, let's move on to the standard deviation. First, enter the values into the formula. Let's take a moment to understand the pattern. The value to the left of the minus sign comes from the data set. The value to the right of the minus sign is the mean that was just calculated. This pattern repeats for all of the points in the data set. The divisor is the number of data points in the data set minus 1. The subtraction is done within the brackets. The values are squared and then added. Finally, the division occurs and the square root is taken. The standard deviation for 1 week of testing of the normal potassium control level is 0.082 millimole per liter. Now that the amount of precision is known, some assumptions can be made about how well this test is performing. You've reached the end of this module. Let's review some basic points. QC statistics for each test performed in the laboratory are calculated from the QC database collected by regular testing of control products. The most fundamental statistics used by the laboratory are the mean and standard deviation. The mean or average is a laboratory's best estimate for the analyte's true value for a specific level of control. To calculate a mean for a specific level of control, first add all the values collected for that control. Then divide the sum of these values by the total number of values. This is the formula for calculating the mean. Standard deviation is a statistic that quantifies how close numerical values, i.e. QC values, are in relation to each other. This is the formula for calculating the standard deviation. The term precision is often used interchangeably with standard deviation. Imprecision is used to express how far apart numerical values are from each other. The repeatability of a test may be consistent, low standard deviation, low imprecision, or inconsistent, high standard deviation, high imprecision. It's desirable to get repeated measurements of the same specimen as close as possible. Good precision is especially needed for tests that are repeated regularly on the same patient to track treatment or disease progress. For all of your laboratory QC needs, go to www.qcnet.com.